We did all kinds of things. We went to doctors. We went to France to drink special water that we said would be the cure. And nothing worked, and no doctors had any advice for us.
יולדת, ואחרי חצי שעה, שעה, אפילו אחרי ששמעו את הבכי של התינוק, התינוק היה נפטר. זה קרה בפעם הראשונה, וגרם כמובן זעזוע במשפחה. זה קרה בפעם השנייה, ולא הבינו מה קורה. וזה קרה בפעם השלישית, כבר הגיעו מים עד נפש ונכנסו לחרדה לא קטנה.
EMS was bringing in a little boy who was involved in a house fire, and they claimed that he didn't sustain any burn injuries, but he had severe smoke inhalation. And I remember sitting down with his father and a mother, and I told them that I was taking care of their child. And I explained that given the amount of smoke inhalation he sustained and the carbon monoxide levels that were in his blood, he was in very critical condition.
The first thing he said, as soon as he looked at us, he said, I give you a bracha you should have in addition to your family within the next year. And I was flabbergasted.
Rebbe smiled and he said, Chas v'shalom, I never said it wasn't good. He said, I just told him not to do it. So I said, well, seeing as he wants to give money, and if the scheme is good, why shouldn't he do it? And the Rebbe smiled even a little more broadly and said, you'll see.
It was absolutely obvious to me that this was the person who the Rebbe had in mind. How the Rebbe would have known that we were going to meet like that is just unbelievable.
אני בן בית אצל הרבה, הרבה גדולי ישראל מכל הזרמים, לאו דווקא כאלה שהולכים בשיטת לובביץ', ואני אמרתי להם, זה סיפור שבדידי אבי עובדי. זה סיפור שאני באוזניי שמעתי ובעיניי ראיתי, לא רק אני.
I said, Gare, that's the power of a bracha. You know, he said a bracha from the Rebbe. I said, in this case, a bracha from the Rebbe. But I said, that was the power of God. You know that you and I have managed other smoke inhalation kids that did not survive. Look at the miracle, it's in your face.